And we're back with a channel update today. Today, just I want to get some information out there because I never really find the correct time during a normal video to put in any information. Normally, I like to get the videos focused on the topic I'm at hand of, and I don't want to waste people's time with just random junk that most people are not interested in. So this is for the people who want to know randomly what's going on in the background and why some things are going the way they're going. For example, the last series there, I haven't quite finished it, but I'm kind of cutting it back. It's just really due to time constraints. At the start, when you do oxygen not included videos, the early game, I can spend maybe 2 hours playing and I'll have a 25, 30 minute episode I can put up just from 2 hours of gameplay. By the time you get to the end, you know, you put in a liquid oxygen, liquid hydrogen build, a couple of Rodriguez's, do some massive upgrades, you put about 16, 20 hours in and all you've got is a 30 minute episode at the end of it. Just it takes a lot more time. So I needed to sort of cut back a little bit because I couldn't continue to keep the quality up, but still keep the length of the videos the same. They were getting quite short there near the end. Just simply ran out of time. However, I'm not finished with that series. I still have to finish that rocket chimney. I know that I got to put an extra few turbines on the left-hand side and a few other bits and bobs, but I will get around to that. I'll just be working on that in the background while I'm still continuing on with episodes. For episodes, I'll probably be doing a few tutorials anyway, just before I go back to do a new game. I'm not sure what I want to do. I've been tempted by a few suggestions. One was maybe do Badlands. Badlands looks like a good map to do because there's no gold amalgam on it, which means you got to change up your build a bit. Though I was also tempted by the idea of just doing a straight up playthrough on normal, as in Terra or Terran. I don't know. I haven't played the Terra map since they patched it. Just to a quick straight-up playthrough going through from start to, say, space. Just a quick playthrough to as more of a demonstration for the newer players, because I suppose we do forget how difficult it was when we first started. So I haven't quite come up with a rock-solid plan on what's going to happen next, but I will be putting up a poll or two in the next... Well, a poll in the next week or two, just based on suggestions I find in the comments. Yeah, and sorry for not getting around to the comments as much. It's just... It's any free time I have generally just goes into trying to get a video out. And any extra free time I might have on top of that, I might just go, well, maybe I'll just put in 5 more minutes and do this thing. My gameplay style pretty much reflects my video creation style. I have a tendency to just get distracted by doing something and then like, oh, just five more minutes. And next thing I know, I've spent all of my free time just working on a video instead of, you know, getting back and responding to the comments. I will try and get around to all of them, but at some point I just have to cut my losses when it gets like, oh, I've got 5 days of comments to go through and that's going to take about 6 hours. Oh no. So I apologize for any I don't get back to. I really do appreciate that people put in time and effort. And if anyone is out there and you see someone asking a question in the comments that you know the answer to, if you could answer their question, that would be great because it saves me answering their question and saves me a load of time. Thank you very much. Also, just thanks to everyone in general for watching the channel. It's been interesting. I've always liked games and, YouTube's technically a game, I suppose. Well, no, it's more a case of I always felt a little bit guilty spending a lot of time playing games. But technically it's a YouTube channel now and, you know, it sort of, I make enough money off it to pay for my other hobbies, which are whiskey and chocolate. And I know what you're thinking. Chocolate's not a hobby. And respectfully, you're doing it wrong. Chocolate can definitely be a hobby. But now I don't feel guilty about doing the gaming, so I can effectively put in, well, you know, it's technically a part-time job sort of thing, so I should really be putting in more time. I've been putting in more time and more effort. You know, I really gotta, like, you gotta buckle down and put in some time and effort on those things. I think I never would have built some of the ridiculous contraptions in ONI or some of the bases, dear Lord. I don't think I could have invested that much time before without feeling, you know, like I was sort of wasting an awful lot of time. But technically, YouTube channel, you know, all works out, pays for my whiskey and chocolate. It has given me a guilt-free life. It's a wonderful gift. I would like to thank you all. This channel has also taught me many valuable things like the pronunciation of words. For example, it turns out fillet is pronounced fillet in parts of France and stuff like that, but in some other parts of the world it's pronounced fillet. I don't know, it got confusing. Beanies are toques, which are really just woolly hats, but a beanie is... Okay, so a toque is the Canadian version. A beanie is... Okay, you know, let's not get into this. This would get rather confusing again. Yeah, just to point out, my pronunciation of many words has improved dramatically from making YouTube videos. It's amazing how much grammar correction I have received. It's kind of, you know, it's almost flattering. It's nice to know that people care these much about the little things. I have also learned other odd things that you wouldn't know. Like, I made that video I made with the water where I dropped ocean on a magma. Well, the thumbnail for that was white ocean on top of sort of the red magma. It had 4% viewers from Poland because it turns out that exact colors matches the flag of Poland. So Polish people somehow got tricked into watching it because they were thought they were watching something on Poland or something like that. It's odd, some of the things that happen on videos. You have no idea. The most popular video by far on the channel that ever happened was how to get over the mid-game hump, which was a request from someone, from a couple of people in the comments, just, you know, how do you get from the mid-game onwards? And yeah, so I put together the video and it turns out that's my most popular video by far. Strange the things that happen. Thanks to everyone for the suggestions in the comments as well. There's quite a few suggestions whose ideas I've stolen. And most of the time I've tried to give credit all the time, but there has been more than a few that I've missed. There'll be a suggestion someone will give you and you're not going that way at the time. And then 5 episodes later, plans change because of something else and you end up somehow nicking their idea, but you've forgotten you're stealing the idea from someone else because it was 2 or 3 weeks ago. And at this point, it's in the back of your brain somewhere. And I apologize for any ideas I've stolen without giving full credit. To you people, big apology, blanket apology all around to everyone. I apologize. I keep trying to give credit, but I sometimes you just miss out. I have a whole bunch of bases I have to do reviews on as well. I've got to go check the mail for the base loving videos. I got to do a bunch of those. I think I'm going to try and slow down and keep to shorter episodes for a bit, or just smaller episodes, so I can cram in some base loving videos. I want to like get those out. But people have sent me a whole bunch of beautiful bases, and I've been kind of spending way too much time doing just straight up playthroughs. As for the Rimworld playthrough, I'm going to keep going with that one. I think the plan there is I want to try and get up to 40 dupes and leave the planet. Well, I'm going to count the dupes that also passed as well, the ones we have in sarcophagus. So if we've got a combination of 40 pawns, not dupes, 40 pawns slash sarcophagi, is it plural of sarcophagus, sarcophagi? You know, it doesn't matter. 40 pawns, living or dead, so long as they're in a sarcophagi or, you know, alive and kicking. Once we've got about 40 of them, I'm going to end that map by, you know, doing some, you know, genocide. It happens in that game. You know, it's technically a war crime simulator. But actually, no. You know what? I wouldn't go as far as to say that. Rimworld can be played any way you want. It's just you have a tendency to do what's best for the colony after a while. That game has taught me that you always start with the best of intentions, and then when people you care about come on the line, you sort of throw all those intentions out the window to make sure that they survive and all the bad guys die. Though I would like to point out, in all fairness, in most situations in life, you don't get attacked by random people all the time and are forced to commit horrible crimes to survive. Still, wonderful game. We'll see where that one goes. Going forward with the channel, at some point I'll be moving to other games and things like that. One I wanted to really do a tutorial on before the new release comes out is, Mountain Blade Warband, because they're bringing out the new version Bannerlord. Well, Bannerlord when, who knows. But they should have Bannerlord out in the next few months, and I'd like to get a quick tutorial up for Mountain Blade Warband, because there's still no good tutorials on that game. You go to look it up and it's, I suppose all the mods took over. It happens. So I'd like to do up a quick one on that. I'd also like to do a playthrough of Kenshi. I haven't played Kenshi at all yet, but I've heard such wonderful, wonderful things. Also, there's Factorio, which I haven't played in about a year and a half, and there's been some upgrades and I'd really like to go back, but that's a huge black hole and a time sink. I'd nearly almost have to give up everything else to go back to Factorio. That thing is, I think that was my first video I ever made, was on Factorio. Oh, another thing. I know this is sort of a rambling channel update, but I didn't make any notes. Notes tend to stifle things and make them feel less natural, in my opinion. Though definitely better organized when you're doing tutorials. And tutorials were the whole reason I started this channel. It was more a case of there was no good, decent tutorials on this, on Oxygen Not Included when I started. I remember when I first played this game, it drove me crazy trying to find anything to do with it. All the tutorials were out of date. They said use abyssalite. The heat deletion mechanics were terrible. I tried watching some YouTubers and the amount of incorrect information they were spouting out after a while just really got me annoyed. So that's the whole reason I started making tutorials was just for that. And then, yeah, somehow I ended up here. God knows how. Life is strange, isn't it? Anyway, I think I'll cut the channel update out here before I wander any further. What you're watching in the background is just some work I was doing on the base. It crashes out later on. I'm terrified to load it back up again to see when the last save was. I'm pretty sure it's every 10 cycles. I really hope it wasn't too far back. Otherwise, I'm going to have lost an awful lot of progress. As you can see, lots of little side work that goes on in the background. Anyway, thanks again for enjoying the channel, and we'll be back to our regularly scheduled. Oh, yeah, I should probably put a schedule up somewhere, shouldn't I? Monday and Thursday is Oxygen Not Included, and Tuesday and Friday is RimWorld. Well, it is for now. We'll see what happens once the RimWorld series ends. I'll probably take a... okay, you know what? We'll find out then. I'm sure I can do another channel update when the time comes. Anyway, hope you enjoyed and good luck.